So today I wanted to talk about diabetic eye disease. I had a patient come to see me recently, and this happens quite frequently actually, that someone gets diagnosed with diabetes, and it hits them all of a sudden, all this information about all these different aspects of healthcare, all the treatments required for the different parts of the body being affected by this disease, and it's a bit overwhelming. And I think we don't always have time in clinic to talk about these things. We're always very good at explaining the rationale for the things we do. So I thought it would be interesting and important to go over things here. So first of all, diabetes, we probably all know, it's a condition where the body's not good at processing sugar. And so the mechanisms for processing the sugar in the bloodstream break down for various reasons. And essentially, you get a high concentration of sugar in your bloodstream. And what's the problem with that? Well, the problem is that our bloodstream, our little blood vessels, are not designed to deal with it. And the little tiny blood vessels throughout the body don't like this high sugar content. And they start to break down and leak and not work properly. And that means that the blood supply to all parts of the body is impaired. So that's why your fingers are affected, your kidneys and your eyes, all places where you've got these tiny little capillaries that are breaking down. And then the eye, specifically in the retina, so that's the wallpaper inside the eye that picks up the light, it's actually the most metabolically active tissue in the body per unit weight. So it uses a lot of oxygen, it uses a lot of nutrients to do its job. And so when it gets deprived of all of those nutrients by this problem with the blood vessels, it starts to get upset and it starts to send out chemical signals saying, I'm in trouble, I need some help. Now, the body's good at trying to repair itself and it hears these signals. And what happens is it starts to grow some new blood vessels to replace the ones that aren't working. But unfortunately, the new blood vessels that it's making aren't good ones, aren't healthy ones. They don't do the job properly. And instead of bringing fresh, good blood to the tissues, they just also leak and bleed and they grow in a wrong way and into the wrong places. And so when we see this in diabetic eye disease, we say, well, look, we need to shut this process down. We need to stop these chemical signals from driving the growth of these abnormal blood vessels. And the traditional way we've done that has been with laser, something called PRP, pan-retinal photocoagulation. So it's where we take a particular subtype of laser we use for the eyes, and we essentially destroy parts of the retina. I mean, that's what we're doing. It's a sort of a burn that kills some of the retinal cells, shuts them down. The end result of that is that those parts of the retina, now this retina isn't healthy. This isn't perfectly healthy, normal retina, which is why we can afford to cause some damage to it, because normally it wouldn't be delivering those visual signals anyway, because of the impaired blood supply to it. By shutting it down with the laser, we're reducing those chemical signals that are being sent out. And so these abnormal blood vessels, this sort of bleeding, sort of disorder, starts to shut down and starts to quieten down. But as it does so, the blood vessels that are there, they turn into scar tissue, which is good. It means they're not going to bleed and leak so much. But unfortunately, the scar tissue itself, the kind of movement of the jelly inside the eye can tug on it. The scar tissue itself can thicken up over time, and that physically can pull on blood vessels and cause bleeding by itself. And so you have these two different types of bleeding issues with diabetic eyes. You have the active disease bleeding, which needs some laser or sometimes some injections into the eye to shut down that process. But you also have the later stage disease where everything is quietening down, and perhaps even as a result of the treatment we've delivered, you can get these other types of bleeds, which we call tractional ones, that are due to the pull on the blood vessels from the scar tissue. And well, I see a lot of these cases because my job as a retinal surgeon is to sort out the scar tissue. So the operations which you sometimes require in later stage diabetic disease, they have to do with removing the scar tissue and reducing the likelihood of the bleeding. So that's diabetic disease in a nutshell.